stop dreaming. We'll be right back.
He made 7 three-pointers for a career-high 23 points in a win over North Dakota. Last spring, he graduated with a degree in general studies, a minor in human services, currently pursuing a master's in organizational leadership. Joined by his parents, Edward and Marcia, from Union City, Tennessee, number 41, Marcus DeBerry. He's drained 135 three-pointers while grabbing 260 rebounds. Last week, he recorded his first career double-double. He made game-winning shots last season at Cleveland State and Oral Roberts. At the conclusion of the season, he was selected to the 2018-19 Summer League All-Newcomer team. Last spring, he graduated with a degree in finance, currently pursuing a master's in organizational leadership. He's joined by his parents, Tom and Denise, sisters Claire and Sarah, and brother Josh from Indianapolis, Indiana. Number 13, Matt Holbaugh. Ladies and gentlemen, please give a final round of applause for our Mastodon senior, Marcus DeBerry, Matt Holbaugh.
Just by attending Mastodon games.
game. We won't have available app and Google Play app stores now. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the Gate Sports Center at Purdue Fort Wayne. Tonight's NCAA and Summer League men's basketball game features the Denver Pioneers and the Purdue Fort Wayne Mastodons. Midwest American Federal Coach and Union panel present our national anthem. This time we ask you to please rise and face the flag. Our national anthem tonight being performed by Natalie Rosal.
Oh, say can you
it's senior night at Purdue Fort Wayne as Matt Holba and Marcus DeBerry look to finish their home careers with a win against Denver. One last time before the Mastodons move on to the Horizon League, it's Summit League hoops in the Summit City. Hi everyone, and a pleasant Wednesday evening to you. Welcome inside the Hilliard Gate Sports Center. Alongside the former Indiana Tech head coach, Jeff Parrish, I'm John Nolan. Glad to have you with us. And Jeff, this season hasn't gone according to plan for Purdue Fort Wayne and seniors Matt Holba and Marcus DeBerry, but they still have a chance to make it special.
Special indeed. Tonight a special night. It's senior night here in the Gate Center. Special moment for both of these guys. Hopefully their parents will be here, and they'll be honored here at center court before the game. Something that is kind of an intimate moment between coach and player and parents and coach, because think about it, when you go off to play Division I basketball, you're pretty much committing a full-time job for 4 years, and that's what these two have done, because you're probably going to be with your coach more than you are with your parents. So there's a lot of trust involved, and it's a very special moment when you get to be honored here tonight before the game.
Yeah, John Kaufman has said he's really enjoyed coaching these two guys and seeing how they have grown and evolved, not only on the court, but off the court as young men as well. And here tonight now, they have a tough challenge against Denver. The Pioneers may be towards the top, or maybe towards the bottom of the standings in the Summit League for the season, but they're riding high right now, fresh off a win last time out over Oral Roberts, one of the better teams in the Summit League this season. As for the Mastodons, last time out, a heartbreaking loss against Omaha. They fell by two in a game that went down to the very last second. Let's take a look back.
Obviously disappointed in the outcome there, and I'll give a lot of credit to Omaha, who they came ready to play. I think they scored a bucket on seven of the first eight possessions, and they came in attack mode. But I thought our group really responded well, and there's some great basketball out there on the floor. But I'm disappointed in the fact that we keep running into the same obstacle where adversity strikes, and then our process isn't very good. And it's not one or two people. It's that group, and it's you know, it's time to put it all, you know, the saying we've put in our locker room this week was it's time to put it all together, together. Okay, it's not a one person, it's as a group. We got to raise our level, and you know, we've worked really, really hard at, you know, body language so it doesn't, you know, pull the group down during adverse moments. We've worked on, you know, you see us touching and clapping and trying to raise that level, the energy level. We've really worked hard on that. We've worked on coming in with the mindset of win ugly, to where just being able to defend. And you guys have seen some unbelievable, you know, defensive games, halves. I mean, the fact that we hold Denver to, I think it was 19, South Dakota State on the road to 26, and then tonight we hold Omaha to 39% shooting, 18% from three, and give yourself a chance by winning ugly. And that's phenomenal. But you got to be able to take care of the ball.
I think we fought all game. You know, we had big emphasis, obviously, this game on rebounding and then transition defense. So we worked on it in practice this week, and it was, like I said, an emphasis of the game today. We struggled a little bit in the first half with the transition defense, but I thought we picked it up, you know, in the second half. Competed, fought till the end. You know, I think we executed at the end, too, and we got a really great look at it to win the game there. And you know, I think we're going to make that one next time.
Just the ability to string stops together. You know, like you said, a big emphasis for us in practice was transition defense. But I think in a half court, we got to do a better job of just getting more stops. I mean, just going out and trying to lead by example. I'm really not necessarily the rah-rah guy on the team, but I just try to go out, play as hard as I can for as long as I'm out there, and just lead by example.
All right, here we go. It's Purdue Fort Wayne in white and Denver on the road in maroon. Our officials tonight, Brett Wajanke, Chad Barlow, and Justin Shamian. And it's Purdue Fort Wayne that starts with possession. Macedon's looking to end a three-game skid and send out Marcus DeBerry and Matt Holba on a high note. And by the way, Jeff, Marcus, who was in the starting lineup during the non-conference part of the season, but has come off the bench in league play, does get a chance to start here on senior night.
And he's handled that situation perfectly throughout his 2 years. He's played in every game here for the Mastodons, and tonight, a class act by Coach Kaufman, putting him in the starting lineup for his final home game here at the Gates Center.
And so it's Brian Patrick who's coming off the bench for the first time all season. Fittingly right there, it's DeBerry to Holba, and an outlet for the point guard, Jared Godfrey. What are you looking for here early on tonight?
Well, number one, the Mastodons, they got to have a good start. We've talked about good starts for the last several years doing these games. They need a good start. We saw the turnover bug bite them last week in that loss at the last second there. Take care of the basketball. Get some points early. Get some easy baskets instead of maybe shooting the three all the time. I'm going to tell you right now, this Denver team, they don't want to be in last place. They want to make the tournament because I guarantee you for Coach Billups, that doesn't do much good for his resume sitting out the conference tournament. They're coming off a big win over Oral Roberts, and hey, they want that last spot to go to the Summit League tournament.
And Denver was the odd man out last year, right now in a tie with Western Illinois. Those two teams actually play each other in Colorado on Saturday. Chase Townsend with a look inside for Robert Jones, who has the first points of the night.
What are you going to see out here in Denver tonight? Maybe one of the prolific scoring combos in college basketball in the backcourt with Dave Murky and Chase Townsend averaging 35 points a game. That's going to be a big task for the Mastodons to handle.
And Townsend just deflected that one to Murky, who's the only senior on this Denver team. 11 of their 13 scholarship players are freshmen or sophomores, including Townsend. He's the leading scorer among sophomores in the conference. Purdue Fort Wayne's Jared Godfrey right behind him. Murky dropped 42 on the road recently at South Dakota State, but in this spot turns it over. John Kaufman in danger of having his first losing season in his sixth year with the Mastodons, but nevertheless has remained optimistic and positive, and thinks this team still does have a chance to put it together when it will count most here come March.
Every time I've talked to Coach Coughlin throughout the year, it's nothing but positive. He loves this kid, these kids on this team. He thinks there's so much room for growth. But they're kind of finding themselves in an unfamiliar position at the bottom part of the standings. Right there, Jared Godfrey gets the Dons off with a big three-pointer there to take the lead.
Godfrey, the team leader in scoring at 15 points a game. Also, the team leader in assists at 3 a contest. Does a little bit of everything for the Mastodons.
As do the two guards from Denver.
No question. Some of the top players in the league here on display. Tristan Green, more of a role player. Into the chest of Matt Holba, who forces a tough shot. DeBerry for 3. Offensive rebound for Dylan Carl. Godfrey finds a cutting Phillips, who banks it in.
Great slash by Phillips that time, coming out of the wing area. Good body control, took the little bump and was able to get it off the backboard for the easy basket.
Denver has been averaging 75 points per game in league play. They've played at the fastest tempo in the entire conference. Purdue Fort Wayne, though, has really been staunch defensively. That's become their identity. Averaging only 70 points per game. That's the fewest for a Mastodons team in 5 years. Carl, good on the assist from the senior Holba.
That's what I like. Two easy baskets. One by Phillips, one by Carl there. Right on the inside, in the paint. That gets confidence built throughout the whole squad. And when that jumper's open later on, they'll be able to knock that down.
See, it's DeBerry who has the assignment on Murky. A miss for Townsend. DeBerry. Carl keeps it alive. Nice pass. And Carl will head to the line when we come back. Almost 5 minutes in, and Purdue Fort Wayne has allowed just 2 points and leads by 5 on senior night.
The Acme Bar and Grill, where neighbors meet. A Fort Wayne tradition since 1941. We feature nightly dinner specials along with our iconic pizza, wings, and pork tenderloins, and barbecue in our family-friendly atmosphere with a retro flair. Additionally, we offer a full bar with 26 beers on tap from various Midwest breweries. We also have an area perfect for private events such as meetings, reunions, and banquets that holds up to 50 people. The Acme Bar and Grill, located in the heart of East State Village, where neighbors meet.
At Diamond Residential Mortgage, we understand the importance of keeping pace with technology, and we offer a completely digital loan process to our customers who choose to take advantage of that option. But we also understand the magnitude of a home purchase, and one of our loan officers will work with you every step of the loan process to make sure all your questions are answered and the right type of loan is tailored to fit your needs. See Diamond Residential Mortgage.
It's senior night at Purdue Fort Wayne, and before the game, the Mastodons recognize Matt Holba and Marcus DeBerry. Marcus joined by his parents, Edward and Marcia, up from Union City, Tennessee. Matt Holba's family had an easier drive coming from the Indianapolis area, and Matt, they're accompanied by his parents, Tom and Denise, as well as his siblings, Claire, Sarah, and Josh, for a special pregame ceremony.
Great night for both of them, a special night, a night that they'll probably remember for the rest of their lives. But you got to remember, it's just tonight. There's still some unfinished business. They got to go on the road to Oral Roberts. The big Summit League tournament follows after that. And then the grand finale is when they walk across the stage at the Coliseum and get that diploma.
And for both those guys, they'll be going for their master's. Holba already with an undergrad degree in finance, DeBerry one in general studies. Redshirt junior Dylan Carl, meanwhile, at the line. He was fouled on a dunk attempt before the timeout. Gets one of two. What advice would you give to your seniors back during your coaching days on a night like this where, yeah, maybe guys could be kind of caught up in the moment?
They got to take it as just another game, all right? Hopefully that their parents have been here before. That's a given. And they got to go out and play, and they got to finish this season off strong just like any other game.
Over there with strong defense to force a turnover.
Granted, their time is, you know, shrinking as the days go by, and maybe a little extra effort. Maybe they do a little extra something to prepare for the game.
Roddy Billups will only have one senior to recognize come Saturday back in Denver. It'll be a day murky. Yes, Billups is the younger brother of the former NBA champion All-Star Chauncey Billups. No relation, though, to Deontay Billups, who kicks for Holba. Both seniors have played well defensively early on as the Macedons have yielded just 2 points. They're on an 8-0 run. No good for Murky. A brick for Tristan Green. And Brian Patrick in off the bench, skying for that rebound.
Good swing, good swing.
Backdoor cut. An excellent pass from Patrick, and Holba right there was pointing to his chest saying, my bad.
That was an awesome pass by Brian that time. Awesome cut for Matt, cutting to the basket there. Could have been a highlight film.
And they're a heady play by Matt, one of the top three-point shooters in the league. At times can be overplayed there on the perimeter. And it took advantage of that.
You saw that right there. Exactly what you said, took advantage of it. His man got out into the passing lane a little bit too far and recognized that. And good basketball move and back cutting.
Well, after a foul on Demir Black, Denver is still looking for its first basket here in about 6 minutes. Good hands by Godfrey. Jared, unable to finish. Patrick on the second effort. That goes. 10-0 run.
Right now, Denver's really struggling offensively, trying to find the hoop. A few turnovers here, some errant shots. They're struggling right now.
Townsend, the floater, left it short. DeBerry pushes. Black gives it up. And now Tion Rollins enters for Black. Rollins, a guy who's been the ninth or tenth man in the rotation throughout the season, but the Dons saw a spark out of him last week.
He came in. Got some key buckets, an assist, played some good defense, and that gives him the minutes here tonight.
And talking with the Purdue Fort Wayne staff, they said he had a strong week of practice as well to build off that. Townsend looking for Jones inside. Well, it was last off the Dons. There's Brett Wedjenke, our lead official tonight. Nice move by Murky, and that ends the drought for Denver.
Murky, their leading scorer at 18 points a game, finally gets the Denver team on track here offensively.
His first two tonight. He's been even better in league play, averaging 21 points per game. That's third most among players in the conference. Rollins there was called for a travel. Low scoring right now, as Purdue Fort Wayne may prefer it. The mantra has been win ugly. Townsend for three with Benford in his face. No foul. Transition for the Mastodons. And it's an offensive foul as Rollins barreled in Alperin Kurnaz.
Yeah, a little out of control. He's got to realize he's not going to be able to jump over the big 6'6 player there. Come to a jump stop, gather himself.
Then a pause as Rollins comes out, but a flop warning was assessed there against Denver's Jace Townsend. Murky. Rebound, Benford. Roscoe Eastman up ahead for Robert Jones. There's a freshman to a freshman.
That's what got the Dons in trouble last week, was turning it over and easy points on the other end. They got to be careful of that here tonight as well.
Phillips, too long from the corner. Yeah, Purdue Fort Wayne at this point already with six turnovers. They had 19 last time out. We heard John Kaufman say it earlier. That proved to be the difference in the two-point loss against Omaha. Right now, it's a four-point Mastodons lead. And downtown Fort Wayne, a look at Promenade Park a few miles away.
All you can eat, now with boneless wings, only at Applebee's.
Dreaming of getting cash back in your pocket with every purchase you make? With a Visa Rewards credit card from Fort Financial, you can earn 1% back on everything you buy. And a low introductory rate of just 3.9% APR, with no annual fees or balance transfer fees, so you can consolidate debt. You even get online access to view transactions or pay bills. Stop by your local branch or fortfinancialcu.org today. Fort Financial. It's time to live your dreams.
Well, Saturday marked the 40th anniversary of USA Hockey's Miracle on Ice, and it was just a few weeks ago that the captain of that team, Mike Ruzioni, was here on campus at Purdue Fort Wayne speaking to students, and Mastodon's head coach John Kaufman had the honor of introducing him.
That'd be quite an honor. Coach Kaufman, the Miracle on Ice, probably has to go down as one of the greatest moments in America's sports history, and will be talked about for years and years to come.
No question about it. And you don't want to say that the Mastodons need a miracle here in this case, but right now 12-17 overall on the year, 5-9 in the Summit League. They've lost three in a row, but they still believe they have a chance to win the Summit League tournament in a couple weeks.
You know, we talked about that throughout the season, that this team is capable, I think, of beating anybody on any given night, as is anybody. But the problem that's going to face the Dakotas in their home arenas or in their backyards, that's always been a tough task for the Mastodons.
Yeah, we've seen them hang with everyone in the league. They just have a number of close losses. Awful start here for Denver. They're 3 of 13 from the field, but Purdue Fort Wayne continues to turn it over. That's 7. Roscoe Eastman sprinting ahead. Denied. The footage of this one midway through the first half will not be sent over to Springfield, Massachusetts and the Hall of Fame. But again, the mantra here for Purdue Fort Wayne, win ugly. And right now they still lead by 4. Godfrey gets it to go.
It's one of my favorite out of bounds plays right there. I think the Don started running that with John Conchar several years ago and got many, many easy baskets off that little curl play underneath the basket.
Conchar, if you missed it, had a really good game with the Grizzlies a couple of nights ago. An NBA career high 8 points to go with 5 rebounds and 4 assists. Earning more and more minutes for Memphis. Deontay Phillips. Purdue Fort Wayne 1 of 7 from behind the arc. Denver on the other side 0 for 4 from distance. G Jones. Godfrey has the loose ball. A lob. And Carl finishes.
That's about the only option Jared had to get the ball to Dylan to get it up in the air and let Dylan go get it. Good pass by Jared.
Jones sticks it in.
Again, like we said earlier, the Mastodons, they're getting their points on the inside. They got to look for Dylan inside, look for some people cutting to the basket. Only 1 for 7 so far from 3-point.
Mastodon second in the league in 3-pointers per game. That has been a calling card for the Dons. Last 4 years, they were top 15 in the country. They have not shot it at quite the same rate this year. Hernaz, rebound Carl.
Denver also have struggling from the 3-point line as well. Haven't made a shot out there yet.
Phillips on the drive, throws it up wildly. Tenacious on the glass, it sets up Patrick. Book it for three.
Yeah, right time. Good little kick out to Brian that time. You can see he had his feet set, hands ready, and he pulled the trigger.
Timeout Denver.
That was almost like a 19, 20-foot free throw.
We'll take a timeout here as well with the Mastodons out in front by 9.
This little pumpkin's Phoebe. She's my baby, and that's why I'm here.
All right, looking for something pooch friendly?
Yes, I want Pumpkin here to feel safe and snuggly when I want to feel rugged.
Well, we got plenty of Jeeps, Durangos, plenty of room for the dog in the back.
How many will fit comfortably?
7 or 8 adults.
How many dogs?
Oh, 11, 12.
Shotgun, BB.
13.
Glenbrook Dodge Chrysler Jeep Ram. We've been fetching deals since 1979.
Drive a Scat Pack Dodge Charger over $10,000 off MSRP with Dodge Power Dollars at Glenbrook Dodge.
Oh, she got a little too excited.
I'll get a towel.
In its fourth decade, the Summit League continues its ascent through excellence in the classroom and success in the field of play. In cities big and small, at public and private universities, more than 120,000 students across 9 institutions reach for the Summit. From academic All-Americans to NCAA champions and nationally ranked teams, Summit League student athletes achieve the pinnacle of success. The Summit League, where tomorrow's leaders reach the summit today.
Purdue Fort Wayne is hosting the University of Denver Pioneers tonight. The private school has an impressive list of alumni, including former Secretary of State Condoleezza Rice, but probably no alum funnier than Sinbad, a.k.a. David Akins, who at 6'6", actually played on their basketball team for a few years in the late 70s. Averaged 4 points, 4 rebounds a game. Not bad.
Not bad for a comedian. I think back then they weren't Division I. They just turned Division I here in the, what, late 90s, I believe?
1998, yep.
And Sinbad, part of that history.
And certainly a rich sports tradition there at Denver. Outside of basketball, saw on the graphic 33 national titles, 13 of them, or I should say more than 13, have come in skiing. They also have 8 men's ice hockey crowns and even 1 in lacrosse. Deontay Phillips all the way to the tin.
Great take by Deontay. That's 12 points in the paint now for the Mastodons out of their 19. And I like that a lot, John, coming out of the Mastodons. Not relying on that 3-point shot every time down the court.
Nice hustle there by Cam Benford as well as Demir Black diving, trying to save that. It does go out, but in addition to that mentality for Phillips of getting to the basket, guys diving all over the floor. Matt Holbus called for the foul. It's only the third against Purdue Fort Wayne.
know. I watched that out of bounds play. There's lob passes over the top of everybody from the baseline night after night, whether it's a high school game, college game, and that just drives me crazy.
Tell us how you really feel.
So many times I see a turnover result in it.
It nearly was intercepted by Holba as that one was straight out of a candy store, lollipop style. Holba. He's been one of the top three-point shooters, not just in the Summit League, but nationally over his career. This year has had to overcome a torn ligament in his index finger on his right shooting hand. For part of the season, was wearing a plastic splint on that finger that affected his shooting percentage. Has been better of late, though. Oh, Billups had trouble on the catch. That could have been showtime otherwise. He's a high riser. Does stay with the Mastodons. It's a snowy day here in Northeast Indiana. If you're just tuning in and you see the score, you might think they're playing the game outside.
Kind of a welcoming card for Denver, bringing in a little bit of snow for him. Make him feel at home.
Matt Holba playing in the final home game of his career. Good from downtown.
Matt's first bucket of the night. Get him on track here, get him loose, and put on a little show for his parents from Indianapolis.
Parents and siblings were with him on the court pregame tonight. The Mastodons have made life tough for a day murky. A skip pass finds Roscoe Eastman, and his shot contested and missed. Rollins. Phillips on a third try.
Good Deontay out there keeping after it. You see the quick jumps right. One right after another to keep that ball alive, and finally got the last one to go in for him.
So springy, and it's an 8-0 run for the Dons. Denver hasn't scored in about 4 minutes. Their leading scorer, Murky. Murky still with just 4 points. Well, Jace Townsend, who averages 17 a game, has not scored yet. One thing about Denver right now, they're a bit worn down. Townsend has a left foot injury a couple games ago. He went scoreless. Now, that said, last time out, almost had a triple-double against Oral Roberts. Offensive foul against Phillips. Called for a push-off. Phillips gets a breather now.
We talked these two guards from Denver that are kind of highly taught at 35 points a game combined, really struggling here this first half. And that's due to the part. I think Ryan Patrick's done a good job. Marcus DeBerry's done a good job, as well as Jared Godfrey. They've all D'd up on these guys and done a nice job.
Yeah, Mastodon's really embracing that identity of being, in some ways, a defense-first team. Benford charging outside there plays a part in that travel call.
Especially, you know, you take that defensive mentality, and if you're not shooting the ball as well as you have in the past years, you got to find something that's going to spark your team, and hopefully it's been on the defensive end, and we've seen that here tonight.
That was a travel on Khalil Johnson, as right now Rodney Phillips looks for a spark on his side. Johnson has only played in 9 games and averaged just 2 minutes a game this year. Still Purdue-Fort Wayne ball. Godfrey gets it back from Benford. Rollins, nearly an and one.
It's a Just can't get one to fall. They're right there. Good ball movement. Good ball fake there by Teon. Got his man moving in the air and he took advantage of it.
For Rollins, it'll be free throws 11 and 12 of the year. 6 for 10 so far. Pretty sound right there for the redshirt freshman from Tallahassee, Florida. First couple points of the night for Teon. Largest lead yet for the Mastodons, up by 16 with 4 to go in the first half. Murky and the Pioneers can't buy one. And Jeff, this is turning into a repeat of the first matchup between these two earlier this month when Purdue Fort Wayne held Denver to just 19 points in the first half. Denver with only 3:46 to go in this first half for a chance to start to climb back in this game as Deontay Phillips and the Mastodons are up 16.
All you can eat, now with boneless wings, only at Applebee's.
At Diamond Residential Mortgage, we understand the importance of keeping pace with technology, and we offer a completely digital loan process to our customers who choose to take advantage of that option. But we also understand the magnitude of a home purchase, and one of our loan officers will work with you every step of the loan process to make sure all your questions are answered and the right type of loan is tailored to fit your needs. See Diamond Residential Mortgage.
Every time you show up, you make the game, and they make history. March 28th and 30th in Fort Wayne, Indiana. Nothing beats the crowd. Visit ncaa.com/WBB tickets to get your seats today.
Mastodon basketball is brought to you in part by Optimum Performance Sports, the official medical care provider of Purdue Fort Wayne. OPS, rethink your limits. On the Purdue Fort Wayne campus here tonight with Jeff Parrish, I'm John Nolan. Glad to have you with us. The Mastodons with a 16-point lead over the Pioneers. Denver coming off of an impressive win last time out over Oral Roberts. A team that when we saw them here last month looked like they could be the class of the Summit League. As it stands right now, it's down to North Dakota State and South Dakota State for a chance to win it all.
You know, as I look over these stats a little bit, Denver, 5 for 24 for only 20%, John. They're not that bad of a shooting team where they're shooting at 45% for the year. They're just having a rough time here tonight, and there's a deep one by Mr. Townsend.
Their first three of the night, Jace Townsend, the sophomore from Dallas.
But I credit that. That's some pretty good half-court defense so far by the Mastodons here, especially on the perimeter.
Yeah, you were talking about it before, the job that Marcus D. Berry in particular has done. A lot of times we've seen him get the assignment of guarding the opposing team's top scorer, whether that be a smaller guard or perhaps a forward.
I think that's where he gets his advantage. He's 6'5", about 200 pounds, and he's taking on these smaller guards, and they can't handle that very well. They can't handle that strength factor.
Holba, the senior, trying to wrap up his home career with a poster, fouled by Robert Jones. Matt Holba saying, I'm not just a shooter.
I think that's how you get torn ligaments in your fingers. Hanging on the rim and snapping it down like that.
Again, Holba has overcome that finger issue this year, and since Summit League play began, he has shot 42% from three, averaging a couple of threes a game. 8th best in the league in those categories. Rare to see him miss a couple at the line. He's a former Indiana All-Star back in high school at Garrett Catholic. Won a Class 3A state title.
number 9 recruit coming out of high school, according to ESPN in the state of Indiana as well. All-state academic. So Coach Coughlin really got a great find when he transferred into Purdue Fort Wayne.
After he started his collegiate career in Pennsylvania at Lehigh. Nice shot fake by Holba. The bounce pass for Carl, who sticks it in.
That's good basketball right there. Great head and shoulders ball fake by Matt. One hard dribble, another fake, bounce pass in to Dylan. See the double team out there on Townsend.
Misses on that three. 2 minutes to go in the first half, and the Macedons are up by 15. A dominant defensive effort so far. Patrick. Godfrey has the takeaway. Phillips throws it too high for the 6'11 Carl. Again, Denver's season low for points and a half, 19. That came at home against Purdue Fort Wayne 2.5 weeks ago. Taylor Gatlin fouled in a long two.
They can keep him at 13 here for the half. That's probably going to be one of the best halves of defense we've seen out of the Mastodons in a long, long time.
Especially considering the opponent, and disregard Denver's record on the year. And they've been playing at the fastest pace in Summit League games, and they have averaged 75 points per game in league play. Taylor Gatlin, a sophomore from Tennessee, an engineering major, misses the first of two. Gatlin has been hobbled of late by a groin injury. Talking before about how Jace Townsend is dealing with a foot injury himself. A couple other Denver players did not make the trip. They're not quite at 100% these days. Godfrey calls a timeout with 1:02 to go in the first half. We'll keep it here.
Obviously, Coach Kaufman, he's going to send something up from the huddle here. Special play. Get somebody open, possibly coming off a screen, shooting a three. We've seen that many times in the past as well.
Again, Purdue Fort Wayne won the first meeting 70-63. That was on the road. So according to ESPN's Basketball Power Index, Macedons given an 80% chance to pull this one out here tonight. If you go by KenPom.com, Purdue Fort Wayne predicted to win 73-67.
See what Coach Kaufman drew up here on the timeout.
Godfrey went around a Holba screen, and Holba is called for an offensive foul.
Kind of stepped out when Jared went around that screen there, but a good call from the bench. I like the call from the bench, trying to get something going to the basket. A powerful screen, and Jared was at full steam ahead getting to the basket. I think he could have probably got all the way to the rim that time if it wasn't for the move on the screen.
Second foul against Holba, so he heads to the bench. One thing to consider for Denver going forward as they continue to look very out of sorts. Cam Benford, Mr. Hustle on the floor. Deep buried to Phillips.
One.
What a shot there by Deontay, switching hands in midair, being able to scoop that up.
That entire sequence is one that the Mastodons coaches may want to cut up. That one's for the season highlight reel.
Look how he switched hands there in midair. Great move by Deontay. Great hustle by Cam Bedford out there in half court, tipping the ball loose on diving into second base there.
Spring training underway elsewhere. We've got snow falling outside here in Northeast Indiana right now as the Mastodons try to close out their regular season home schedule with a victory.
See if they can get a stop here in this possession, John. That'll be quite a feather in their hat. Only giving up 14 points at halftime.
Remarkable.
There you go.
David Nezakwesi posting up. Ade Murky, desperation three, no good. Godfrey, a chance to beat the buzzer. And has that one swatted by Taylor Gatlin. But nevertheless, just about all Mastodons there in that first half.
Great effort, hustle effort on defense. They know what their assignments are, especially on the perimeter of Murky and Townsend. You can see when they come off of ball screens, they're double teaming those two guys, and they have not been able to get on track right now. We've talked earlier, those two combined for 35 points a game, and they've been virtually shut down here the first half.
Yeah, an underwhelming effort from Denver in the first half, while the Mastodons trying to stick with that mentality of win ugly. Coming up now on the Lutheran Health Network Halftime Report, highlights and stats from this first half, as well as a check on Mastodon's men's volleyball and women's basketball. But first, on the other side, a review of the road to Sioux Falls for the Summit League Tournament. That's next.
The Acme Bar and Grill, where neighbors meet. A Fort Wayne tradition since 1941. We feature nightly dinner specials along with our iconic pizza, wings, and pork tenderloins and barbecue in our family-friendly atmosphere with a retro flair. Additionally, we offer a full bar with 26 beers on tap from various Midwest breweries. We also have an area perfect for private events such as meetings, reunions, and banquets that holds up to 50 people. The Acme Bar and Grill, located in the heart of East State Village, where neighbors meet.
Dreaming of getting cash back in your pocket with every purchase you make? With a Visa Rewards credit card from Fort Financial, you can earn 1% back on everything you buy. And a low introductory rate of just 3.9% APR, with no annual fees or balance transfer fees, so you can consolidate debt. You even get online access to view transactions or pay bills. Stop by your local branch or fortfinancialcu.org today. Fort Financial. It's time to live your dreams.
This little pumpkin's BB. She's my baby, and that's why I'm here.
All right, looking for something pooch-friendly?
Yes, I want Pumpkin here to feel safe and snuggly when I want to feel rugged.
Well, we got plenty of Jeeps, Durangos, plenty of room for the dog in the back.
How many will fit comfortably?
Seven or eight adults.
How many dogs?
Oh, 11, 12.
Shotgun, BB.
13.
Glenbrook Dodge Chrysler Jeep Ram. We've been fetching deals since 1979.
Drive a Scat Pack Dodge Charger over 10,000 off MSRP with Dodge Power Dollars at Glenbrook Dodge.
Oh, she got a little too excited.
I'll get a towel.
Purdue Fort Wayne basketball. Buy your tickets now.
Hello, nothing is decided yet as we take the final turn on the road to Sioux Falls and the Summit League basketball championships that get started coming up on March 7th in Sioux Falls. South Dakota State and North Dakota State men are still in the running to claim the regular season championship and the top seed in the postseason tournament. South Dakota State is 13-2 in league play. After a win over South Dakota on Sunday, freshman Noah Friedel with 26 points as the Jacks beat the Coyotes 85-80. North Dakota State, meanwhile, is a game and a half back, 11-3 in the league after a loss at North Dakota on Saturday. Marlon Stewart had 35 points and a three in the final second as the Fighting Hawks beat the Bison 71-68. So, last games of the regular season are this week, and it looks like this. South Dakota State plays at North Dakota State on Thursday. If SDSU wins, the Jacks are the regular season champions. If North Dakota State wins that game, the Bison can still be the co-champs if they go on and beat Omaha on Saturday. The Jacks and the Bison are going to be the top two seeds no matter what happens. But the 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and the 8 spots in the tournament yet to be decided. South Dakota has one game left. That is at home against North Dakota. If the Coyotes win that one, USD is the 3 seed, because even if Omaha ends up with 10 wins and ties USD, USD beat Omaha twice this season. But you get the picture. Things are still very fluid. As they say, Denver and Western Illinois will play each other in Denver on Saturday, and it might come down to that game to see which one of those two teams makes the Summit League tournament. Meanwhile, congratulations to the South Dakota women on earning the regular season title. They wrap it up with a 77-67 win at South Dakota State on Saturday. The Coyotes are 15-0 and could be on their way to a second undefeated regular season in the last 3 years. USD will close out the regular season on Saturday with a home game against North Dakota. The Yotes will go into the Summer League tournament as the top seed for the fourth time now in the last 6 years. South Dakota State's going to be the 2 seed. The Jacks will finish the regular season on Thursday with a road game at North Dakota State. Western Illinois needs one win to wrap up the 3 seed, but the Leathernecks have 2 tough road games left. They're at Oral Roberts on Thursday and at Denver on Saturday. Denver has won 4 games in a row, by the way, to move into the 5 spot at the moment. North Dakota State looking like they will be the 6. UND looking like the 7. And Omaha got a big win at Fort Wayne on Saturday to move ahead of the Dons for 8th place and the last spot in the Summit League tournament.
The Summit League tournaments are live on Midco Sports Network. Watch all the action and check out bonus coverage online and on our social media channels. Midco SN is your tournament headquarters.
Purdue University, Fort Wayne, where ambition meets action, where 10,000 Mastodons gather each year to pursue an education with purpose, all seeking a prestigious Purdue University degree. With our 5 colleges, we graduate artists, scientists, teachers, entrepreneurs, inventors, programmers, economists, business professionals, musicians, thinkers, and creators. All difference makers and world changers. Among those students are the Purdue Fort Wayne student athletes, the dunkers, spikers, and sprinters who fuel pride in our campus. They excel in more than competition. Our student athletes consistently average GPAs north of 3.0. They come to us from 20 states and 13 countries, and they contribute more than 3,000 hours of community service each year. Purdue Fort Wayne is where education, work, and life come together to maximize student success and opportunity. Our small class sizes foster big personal growth, resulting in boundless opportunities. Our campus attracts talent, amplifies it, and sends it back out into the world. Our outstanding faculty members work with, nurture, and support our students. From orientation through commencement, they often form lifelong bonds. We're about change and impact, taking an idea and putting it into action. We're about challenging our students to achieve more, to develop the critical thinking and skills to take on the world. We're about groundbreaking research that allows our students to work alongside faculty to pursue the real-world application of knowledge. We're about a vibrant and active campus. We're about co-ops and internships and partnerships that provide exceptional career opportunities for our students. It's no surprise that Purdue Fort Wayne is a powerful economic engine for our region, our state, and beyond. Our alumni have an annual economic impact of $11 billion on the Hoosier State and fuel more than 100,000 jobs a year. Our campus is the epicenter of culture and entertainment for the region, hosting hundreds of events, lectures, music and theater performances, exhibitions, and NCAA Division I athletic events annually. We embrace cultural diversity and have become the university of choice for students from nearly 50 countries. And for our Mastodons who want to see the world, we offer more than 500 study abroad opportunities. Purdue Fort Wayne is about Fort Wayne. It's not just a city, it's our home. It's what binds us together and sets us apart. It's large enough for opportunity and small enough to make anyone feel right at home. This is our city. This is our university. And this is an education with purpose. We are Purdue University, Fort Wayne.
Tonight's match was no different than last night. I mean, we had to grind and show some guts after losing that opening set. And I thought the guys really showed a level of maturity that I hadn't seen all season. They really, really stepped up their game, and they were steady throughout. And that's pretty impressive against this very good Buckeye squad.
I think we started a little passive with the defense. As the game went on, we realized there's some tendencies going on. And obviously, as the game goes on, the body wears out, you know, and they started getting tired. We started getting some touches, making them think. And I think that was the biggest part. I mean, when we started getting strappy touches, even though they were ugly, we got the ball up. And, you know, and the ball is more time in the air, and it's hard for them to score. So we had more chances there off of our digs, and we converted. So that was the difference, I think.
Well, in the first two games, they were hitting pretty well, so we had to make some adjustments to stop them, the pin hitters, and we made them both in the front court and in the back row, and we started digging some balls, we started touching some blocks, we started blocking balls, and that's how the game changed. They couldn't hit as well as they did in the beginning, and good for us.
This is one of those fun games that we look forward to every year, specifically because we get the opportunity to help raise money for a great cause. Our partnership with Vera Bradley Foundation for Breast Cancer Research is second to none. They come out and give us an opportunity to have a platform to raise awareness. And through the funds that we can help donate, they're doing a really nice job of helping us find a cure. You know, all three seniors have done a nice job of helping us revamp our culture and build a culture. They set a standard of excellence in the classroom, and they're very high character kids. Anna's been here for 4 years in a Macedon jersey, and every single day she goes out and gives you everything that she has. Her defensive intensity and energy for all 4 years has been unmatched, and it really has set the tone for everybody who has come and joined the program as well. Hannah Albright joined us as a transfer, and for her, I can't say enough about her. She's been a good leader on and off the court, faced a lot of adversity this year, but definitely has been, for us, a vocal leader and a leader by example. And then you have Shatoya. Shatoya has been a defensive presence for us. She brings a lot of energy, and we're going to miss all three of them.
I've never heard him say it. How does he? Oh.
Next play, brother.
11%! The team.
Attack.
Ride the wave, brother.
Pace.
Come on, D.
I don't want anyone to bust my chops.
Back inside the Gate Sports Center on the campus of Purdue Fort Wayne with Jeff Parrish, I'm John Nolan. We thought the Macedon's defense was impressive against Denver the first time they met, even better here tonight.
Hold them to only 14 points, 21% shooting from the field for Denver. Fort Wayne's done a great job of defending the perimeter, defending the arc, only 1 for 9, three-point land for Denver as well. And when they got two of the high scoring guards in the Summit League in Merkey and Townsend, they've held them in the check, I think, to only 4 points or 7 points combined. So they're doing an excellent job on the perimeter defending them. But what I like the most, John, out of the Mastodons the first half, 21% from the three-point line. Where have they got their points from? They're taking the ball to the basket. They're getting the ball into the paint. They got 18 points of their 31 in the paint. I like that. They're not settling on that three-point shot like we've seen several times throughout the year.
Our stats are brought to you by PolyPro Concrete Coatings, and definitely ugly there on the left side of the screen. And for the Mastodons, really all things considered, for as strong as the defense was, still far too many turnovers, and they didn't shoot the ball as well as they usually do, especially from three.
No, they didn't shot it very well, you know, from deep, and the turnovers have to be a big concern for the coaching staff, especially starting out here in the second half. Big crucial 5 minutes here. One thing I did notice, John, with the Denver team, when they came out of the locker room here at halftime for their halftime warm-ups, was they really weren't into it. Body language was a little shaky. They were probably waiting to get on that bus, get to the airport or wherever they're going to next, and get out of town. But I didn't see that burn in them, and they were just kind of lackluster in their halftime warm-up. So we'll see what they could do here to start the second half. But the Mastodons' main focus has to be take care of the ball, and you put them away here in the first 5 minutes. Don't let them have a chance.
Over the course of the season, Denver has been a team that has had a no-quit attitude. Example, last time out against Oral Roberts, they trailed by 11 with only 12 minutes to go, and then came back to win 100-96 in overtime. In that first meeting against Purdue Fort Wayne this year, they turned what was a double-digit Dons lead into a two-possession game in the final stages. We'll see what they have in them here in this second half. One thing that is interesting to consider in terms of their team psyche is that in all likelihood their season comes down to Saturday against Western Illinois, the team that they're currently in a tie with for last place in the league, with the loser of that game being the odd man out. Now, the one exception would be if Denver falls in this game and Western Illinois manages to win on the road at Oral Roberts tomorrow night. Well, then it doesn't matter what happens on Saturday, as Western Illinois would have the advantage.
And a footnote to all that, Denver hasn't won a road game all season.
Great point. And not only that, they've actually lost 23 consecutive games on the road. Last road victory came at Wyoming in December of 2018. So along the way, they've dropped 15 straight away from Denver. Deontay Phillips getting up.
Good player movement right there. Good recognition by Dylan. Great basket cut by Deontay for the dunk. That's good basketball right there. I love that. Basket cuts, player movement, easy basket to finish it.
Ade Murky knocks it down over Phillips.
It's their second three-pointer of the game. They're going to have to keep an eye on that, make sure that doesn't come a habit here in the second half.
Murky, same spot, same result. All of a sudden, six straight for Denver to pull within 13. Got a note from Derek Sloboda, Purdue Fort Wayne's assistant athletic director for media services, that for the Mastodons, the 14 points that they held Denver to in the first half mark a Division I program record for fewest points against a Division I opponent. And the defense on display right there. Holba and Carl both contesting. Now it's Godfrey in transition by Townsend, no. Mastodons have the offensive rebound.
Here we go, up and down, up and down.
More of the pace that Denver typically plays at, but the Mastodons controlled the tempo in the first half. Murky all of a sudden has caught fire, and John Kaufman will call a timeout. So Ade Murky, who was a non-factor in the first half, all of a sudden starting to feel it. Three consecutive threes, and the deficit trimmed down to 10 for Denver.
Maybe that body language coming out at halftime, that was maybe their motivation to come out here and have a hot start to the second half. But they're on fire right now. Coach Coughlin, he's got to gather the troops, and he's got to come up with an answer to that three-point plays now. Three straight. We haven't seen that all game long out of the Pioneers.
This little pumpkin's BB. She's my baby, and that's why I'm here.
All right, looking for something pooch-friendly?
Yes, I want Pumpkin here to feel safe and snuggly when I want to feel rugged.
Well, we got plenty of Jeeps, Durangos, plenty of room for the dog in the back.
How many will fit comfortably?
Seven or eight adults.
How many dogs?
Oh, 11, 12.
Shotgun, BB.
13.
Glenbrook Dodge Chrysler Jeep Ram. We've been fetching deals since 1979.
Drive a Scat Pack Dodge Charger over 10,000 off MSRP with Dodge Power Dollars at Glenbrook Dodge.
Oh, she got a little too excited.
I'll get a towel.
My philosophy has always been, what would I do if this was my mother?
You have the blessing from God to know that you're serving in a capacity that you truly love. This isn't a job to me.
They're coming to us at their most vulnerable. They're coming to us at a time when they're dealing with something totally unexpected.
And when you see people go through that every day, it kind of gives you motivation to be your best.
We have some of the best clinical staff that I have ever worked with in my 20-some years of healthcare.
The regular season in the Summit League wraps up on Saturday, and at this point, Purdue Fort Wayne is the only team locked into its seed for the conference tournament. Our standings are brought to you by Three Rivers Federal Credit Union.
It's always an interesting time of the year when you get down to the final week and people are jockeying for position. And as you just said, the Dons pretty much know what their fate is right now.
So they'll be the seventh seed. They'll play the late game on Saturday night, March 7th. They don't know yet, though, whether or not they'll play North Dakota State or South Dakota State. Dylan Carl puts it in.
Nice jump hook. I like that move out of a big man. I like that move out of anybody in the lane, that jump hook. And it's so hard to defend.
Something that Carl has added to his game over his first few years with the Dons. Started as more of a perimeter-oriented big man. Taylor Gatlin, no good. Robert Jones, unable to corral an offensive rebound. And now John Coughlin tells his team to play with pace. Dave Murky stuffs Jared Godfrey. Murky, a deep three. Oh, he's on fire. He's made four in a row over the last few minutes.
I guess that gave him the license to look over to the Purdue Fort Wayne bench after he made that fourth one in a row.
Well, now though, he's called for a foul on D. And it sends us to a break in the action. Under 16 to go. Macedon still up by nine.
All you can eat, now with boneless wings, only at Applebee's.
Dreaming of getting cash back in your pocket with every purchase you make? With a Visa Rewards credit card from Fort Financial, you can earn 1% back on everything you buy. And a low introductory rate of just 3.9% APR, with no annual fees or balance transfer fees, so you can consolidate debt. You even get online access to view transactions or pay bills. Stop by your local branch or fortfinancialcu.org today. Fort Financial. It's time to live your dreams.
Tonight is Purdue Fort Wayne's final home game as a member of the Summit League before moving on to the Horizon League next year. So tonight's the final Purdue Fort Wayne home game as a member of the Summit League before moving on to the Horizon League next year. Remember, the Mastodons went from Division II to D1 in 2001. Joined the Summit in 2017. a highlight along the way, reaching the league championship game in 2014. After that, head coach Tony Jacek left for Jacksonville, but the Mastodons haven't missed a beat under the direction of John Kaufman. Led by Max Landis, they had a regular season title and a trip to the NIT in 2016. Then back-to-back upsets against IU, including a win over the Hoosiers here in Fort Wayne when they were ranked third in the country. John Conchar, a key to both of those victories. This year now, making his debut in the NBA with the Memphis Grizzlies as he goes down as the best player in program history. All that said, Jeff, there's still a final chapter to be written as the Mastodons' one big box that they haven't checked off would be making the big dance.
And I'm sure that's in the back of all their minds heading into the last week of the season and as they get ready to go to Sioux Falls. Gonna make one big splash in the Summit League before they leave.
And trying to build some momentum before that. They've led Denver here tonight just about wire to wire at this point, and they've led by as many as 19, but led by the hot shooting of number zero, Ade Murky, who's knocked down four threes in this second half. Denver has made it a single-digit difference.
And it's given them confidence and given them a little life, and this could be a battle going down to the stretch here.
And don't forget, last time out, the Pioneers overcame an 11-point deficit against Oral Roberts to rally and win. That won't help the cause, though, as David Enzekwesi is called for a travel.
Purdue Fort Wayne's got to get back to that mindset of that good half-court defense on the perimeter, especially like they did the first half. Rebound the ball, run the break, get the ball inside, and get some easy baskets, as we saw a lot happen in the first half.
On senior night for the Mastodons, it's one of the seniors, Matt Holba, playing catch with Deontay Billups, the freshman. Offensive rebound, Cameron Benford. He's top 10 in the league in that category. Holba! Ade Murky coast to coast, misses. Billups pushes. Mastodon selective. Patrick, catch and shoot. Mastodon scoreless here for 3+ minutes. They're 1 for their last 10, including 1 of 8 from three. Patrick, little shake, but turns it over.
Right there, quite sloppy that time there in the half court offense. They just got to regroup, reset the ball, take the ball from the top, and just regroup.
Looking to get a stop right now. Shot clock under 10 for Murky.
And another turnover.
It's 13 for the Pioneers. Mastodons have 15. Holba. Last time out, did they put lids on the rims?
Must have. Both teams struggling right now offensively, where Denver came out smoking hot. Maybe a little fatigue starting to catch up with the Pioneers.
Murky guarded by Billups. Shot clock under 5. A teardrop for Townsend, and it falls. Once down by 19, Denver has pulled within 7.
That's what worries me right here, John, is Townsend. He hasn't really done much yet this game. If he gets hot, as long as Murky gets hot, they both get hot, we're in trouble.
Billups will head to the line. Goes against Murky. Second on him. Deontay attempting to catch his breath before heading to the line. There are the numbers tonight for the freshman from Moline, Illinois in the Quad Cities area. Right now, flirting with a double-double. He had his first career double-double in the first matchup against Denver this year. It's Demir Blackett off the bench with Tion Rollins as John Kaufman searches for some fresh legs and a spark.
We've seen Tion do that here in the last couple weeks. Coming off the bench, getting a good bucket, maybe an assist, defensive stop. Let's keep an eye on him and see what he does here.
A whistle away from the ball, and it'll go on Rollins.
See right there, Tion trying to step in and take that charge, trying to make something happen on the defensive end.
Second foul on the redshirt freshman. Townsend. Off of Denver. Well, the Pioneers, even as they match their offensive output from the first half here in the first 8 minutes of the second half with 14 points, still shooting just 28% for the game. The Mastodons, though, at 33%. Rollins for three. Got it.
Right there, steps into the game, knocks down the big shot right away.
Macedon's recruited him as a shooter. Hasn't necessarily shown that in his first year on the floor, but he's capable.
I can remember him in one of the preseason scrimmages earlier this year. He's one of the guys I think I even told you that I was really impressed with.
Really quick. At times has experienced some growing pains, but trending up here as the season starts to wrap up. 11 and a half minutes to go, and it's the Dons up by a dozen.
$12.99, all you can eat. Now with boneless wings, only at Applebee's.
Dreaming of getting cash back in your pocket with every purchase you make? With a Visa Rewards credit card from Fort Financial, you can earn 1% back on everything you buy. And a low introductory rate of just 3.9% APR, with no annual fees or balance transfer fees, so you can consolidate debt. You even get online access to view transactions or pay bills. Stop by your local branch or fortfinancialcu.org today. Fort Financial. It's time to live your dreams.
Well, we were talking before about some of the highlights for Purdue Fort Wayne over the course of its time in the Summit League, but next year the Mastodons will be in the Horizon League, and primarily for geographic reasons, and you can see why.
Exactly. Travel is going to be cut down hugely in the Horizon League. I want to tell you something, the competition's going to go up big time as well. You got some teams in there that they're a little familiar with. They used to play in the conference with IUPUI. They used to be with Oakland back in the day as well. There'll be some familiar foes there, but some very, very good teams as well. I'm excited to see Green Bay play. I'm excited to see Wright State. See what they got, they're all about. Good teams.
And in recent years in non-conference play, the Dons have seen some of those opponents like UIC, Cleveland State, and like you said, IUPUI, Denver as well.
See Denver here gonna try to pick up the pace a little bit, see if they can turn the Mastodons over, come out with the full court press. As they do.
Townsend to Jones with authority.
Right here we go. Full court press.
Gatlin the steal. Townsend the finish plus the foul.
What a great move by Rodney Billups in that timeout, coming out with that full court press. Caught the Mastodons a little off guard. turned them over two times. Turn that into 4 points, possibly five here with the end one.
And with that, now Rollins out of the game, and the starting point guard, Jared Godfrey, back in. Townsend can't convert on the three-point play. And now Deontay Phillips returns for the Mastodons as well. How do the Mastodons want to beat this pressure?
Want to get the ball in the middle. We're going to reverse the ball in the backcourt. Look for somebody maybe flashing in the middle. As you can see, the middle of the court is wide open. Turn and then attack the basket.
Good cut! And Phillips is going to the line. Dylan Carl at 6'11", great perimeter skills, including his passing ability. And he found the streaking Phillips.
We see Deontay with some good basket cuts throughout the night. That time he was going to really try to jam that one down, but got fouled.
Phillips already over his season average for points per game. You can see the swat there by Gatlin. As a matter of fact, for Phillips, he's been the highest scoring true freshman for the Mastodons in 6 years since Mo Evans, who went on to become an All-Summit League caliber player.
Foul play! No fouls!
Robert Jones in the high post.
Crowd! Gotcha!
Denver's star senior, Ade Murky, currently with it on the wing. Still Denver ball with five on the shot clock.
Look for them trying to get something on the inside here.
Back screen! Back screen!
You can see him jammed up in the lane.
Catch and shoot for Townsend, short. Foul against Purdue Fort Wayne.
Well, the third foul in the half for the Mastodons. So they can be plenty aggressive here with only 10 minutes to go in the game.
Ryan Patrick checking in for Matt Holbo while Cameron Benford replaces Dylan Carl.
That play, my famous play right there, the big lob pass inbounds.
Should we name it after you?
No.
So it's like when they name a highway after someone and then it has nothing but traffic. Murky and the Pioneers back within eight.
There's that full court pressure right now. It's just a straight up man-to-man full court pressure. Just zigzagging their man, looking to run some time off that shot clock. The Mastodons get the ball now to set their offense up. What that does is that shrinks the shot clock down quite a bit.
It's down to 10 here. DeBerry. Phillips went 20 feet high for the rebound. Bedford. A whistle caps the basket.
Got an injured player, Gatlin, there from Denver, limping off the floor. The official caught that right away.
Denver head coach Rodney Phillips has commended the toughness of Taylor Gatlin, who recently has been playing with a groin injury. And he helped to coax them to an upset win over Oral Roberts last time out. Now our officials are over at the monitor.
Mainly they want to see if there was any kind of pushing or shoving going on that play that Gatlin got bumped on.
Yeah. see what they're checking out.
Looks all pretty clean right there. You can see Gatlin at the top of the key got bumped. I don't think there's really...
Potentially they were checking to see if there may have been an elbow, but clearly there wasn't. The body language of one of the officials suggested that he wasn't sure either why they were going to the monitor. Well, Jeff. All of a sudden, that was Chad Barlow getting into a sprint. Faster than the folks we saw over at the Lutheran Health Network Fieldhouse across the hallway earlier tonight. But in case you were wondering whether or not Denver would bring it here in the second half, because again, in all likelihood, whether or not they escape the basement and qualify for the Summit League tournament comes down to how they perform against Western Illinois on Saturday, barring a Western Illinois upset win at ORU tomorrow night. But here they are, exerting a lot of energy, pressing, trying to rally.
Pressing, you know, trying to turn over the Mastodons. And like I just said earlier, with this man, little half or little full court man-to-man press does, it takes time off the shot clock. Purdue Fort Wayne just cannot bring the ball up the floor and survey the court. They got to be intense and they got to take care of the ball. Then once they get into their offense, there's a few more seconds run off that shot clock and possibly got to hurry into their offense.
New shot clock now after an offensive rebound for Deontay Billups. How about that advantage on the glass here for Purdue Fort Wayne so far tonight?
That's a large part of Cam Bedford, Dylan Carl. They're crashing the boards, trying to limit them to the second shots.
A key stat in this game, in particular, offensive rebounding, as the Mastodons have 12 offensive rebounds to only 2 for Denver. D. Berry with the step back J. Another offensive rebound for Bedford. Godfrey. Well, thanks to that rebounding, the Dons have overcome 18 turnovers and just 32% shooting. Both teams have shot it dreadfully at 32%.
That's why I think Purdue Fort Wayne, they got to be careful shooting that three-pointer up. Be a little more patient, see what they can get on the inside, and another turnover.
Yuck. Under 8 timeout, 7:23 left. Purdue Fort Wayne trying to win ugly. And Howe up 44-36.
In its fourth decade, the Summit League continues its ascent through excellence in the classroom and success in the field of play. In cities big and small, at public and private universities, more than 120,000 students across 9 institutions reach for the Summit. From academic All-Americans to NCAA champions and nationally ranked teams, Summit League student athletes achieve the pinnacle of success. The Summit League, where tomorrow's leaders reach the summit today.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and down.
Look at the Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. Memorial Bridge, a gateway to downtown Fort Wayne, and a few miles away here at Purdue Fort Wayne. We remind you that Mastodon basketball is brought to you in part by CVS. Have you had your flu shot yet? If not, visit the CVS on Hobson Road next to Purdue Fort Wayne Student Housing. It's free with most insurance, and you can walk in without an appointment. Don't be caught with the flu this year. Visit CVS. With Jeff Parrish, John Nolan, thanks for making us part of your Wednesday night. Final home game of the regular season for Purdue Fort Wayne, senior night. And Matt Holba, Marcus D. Berry, and the Mastodons lead Denver by 8 with under 8 to go. Chase Townsend into the paint and scores.
Now we're in dangerous territory right here, John. That lead has been cut big time. Mastodon's got to run good offense here. They don't need to play with pace. They just need to control the ball, limit the turnovers, where we got 19 turnovers right now. Good ball movement, good player movement, good shot selection.
It's Godfrey for 3. John Kaufman in the background there saying great look, but his team's just 4 of 26 from 3. Townsend left it short. Mastodons have led by as many as 19 in this second half. Now as close as it's been since the opening minutes.
You can see him moving the ball. Good player movement right there. Keon almost got himself in trouble, but got bailed out there by the official on the reach-in.
Foul on Roscoe Eastman. It's only 4 fouls, though, against Denver. Neither team yet in the bonus.
Here, Coach Kaufman yelling, hard cuts, hard cuts. A lot of ball screens coming off the screens. They got to be careful so they don't get double teamed.
Phillips looking to initiate, and he's fouled.
Took one right there in the thigh, took a knee.
Foul on the big man, Robert Jones. Deontay still stretching out that leg now before going to the line. On the cusp of what would be his second double-double of his freshman season. The first came against Denver earlier this month. What do you think the future could hold for him going forward?
I think he'd be one of the premier players in the Horizon League for the Mastodons. Him and Jared, I think, will be coming back next year. Look for those two to be breakout players in the new league next year. Obviously, if things go well, he will obviously be a 1,000-point scorer. We talked about that with Jared last year with the valuable minutes he got as a freshman. And Deontay, with the unbelievable minutes he's been getting here this year, I think the sky's the limit for that. He's going to, I think he's going to do good things.
Coaches have raved about how coachable he is, his work ethic, his smarts.
I remember when I first talked to Coach Kaufman in the fall about the team, Deontay was one of the guys he first mentioned.
Thrust into a starting position here in Summit League play. Don't look now, but Denver has turned a 19-point deficit into a 5-point game. Holba for 3. Good, and a foul.
Huge basket right there by Matt. Don't really understand what the Denver player was thinking about doing that time. You're not going to be blocking 3-point shots. They got to close out, just get a hand up.
Tristan Green, a sophomore who transferred in from Ranger Junior College, the culprit there. And here on senior night, a chance at a 4-point play for the redshirt senior.
But nonetheless, a big basket for the Mastodons. Badly needed.
And now a steal. Godfrey, all by himself. A 5-point run for the Mastodons with just over 5 minutes to go. Forces Rodney Phillips to use a timeout. It's only a 30-second timeout. Gives us a chance to see another look at the step back three on the dribble for Holba. And how about right there? Takes the guns out of the holster. Bang, bang.
Bang, bang. Big boost for the Mastodons right there out of the senior. Let's see if he can finish this out here in the last 5 minutes of the game.
Dan Holba this year has overcome a torn ligament in his index finger on his shooting hand, his right hand. And he has been really the vocal leader for this team. When you look at the two seniors, Holba and Marcus D. Berry, Marcus admittedly pretty soft-spoken, not a rah-rah kind of guy. Probably get more rah-rah out of the pep bands here. And how about them styling here tonight? Some seniors in that group looking good and sharp. Sounding dressing good, up too. But that said, Holba and D. Berry, they've taken it upon themselves to try to keep this team together. Remember, this is Purdue Fort Wayne's first losing season in 6 years. Could be easy to have some conflict in the locker room, maybe some finger pointing. That has not been the case with these Mastodons.
That's a huge credit to the coaching staff to keeping things in check, always communicating with the players, constantly communicating. They have not let these guys drift it off at all. They put their thumb on them and kept them in check.
Remember John Kaufman's line these last couple weeks has been, it's time to put it all together, together. Carl, the mid-range J. Does Denver have anything left in the tank? Townsend, who's playing through a foot injury.
I think that three-point basket by Matt and that breakaway layup by Jared, they could have just taken the wind right out of their sails here with 4 minutes to go.
Herky misses, Green does it.
To me, that ball's on the rim and should have been neglected right there. The referee missed that one.
Under four to go, Don's up by eight.
Here, Coach Kaufman yelling, mature, mature, mature. He's got his two most mature players on the floor right now to finish this out.
Holba and D. Berry. Murky, the only senior for Denver, is fouled by D. Berry. It'll be Denver ball on the baseline after this. Final home game of the regular season for Purdue Fort Wayne and the Mastodons trying to send their seniors out with a victory. Back with the final 3:26 from the Gate Sports Center coming up next.
This little pumpkin's BB. She's my baby, and that's why I'm here.
All right, looking for something pooch friendly?
Yes, I want Pumpkin here to feel safe and snuggly when I want to feel rugged.
Well, we got plenty of Jeeps, Durangos, plenty of room for the dog in the back.
How many will fit comfortably?
Seven or eight adults.
How many dogs?
Oh, 11, 12.
Shotgun, BB.
13.
Glenbrook Dodge Chrysler Jeep Ram. We've been fetching deals since 1979.
Drive a Scat Pack Dodge Charger over 10,000 off MSRP with Dodge Power Dollars at Glenbrook Dodge.
Oh, she got a little too excited.
I'll get a towel.
In its fourth decade, the Summit League continues its ascent through excellence in the classroom and success in the field of play. In cities big and small, at public and private universities, more than 120,000 students across nine institutions reach for the Summit. From academic All-Americans to NCAA champions and nationally ranked teams, Summit League student athletes achieve the pinnacle of success. The Summit League, where tomorrow's leaders reach the summit today.
Well, at this time, we generally hand out our Player of the Game Award presented by Connor's Kitchen and Bar in downtown Fort Wayne, but here it's our final broadcast of the season from Purdue Fort Wayne, and we thought it would be a good time to highlight the folks behind the scenes on our crew. There was Bill and Lana up top, Matt on the baseline camera here tonight, along with Don, and so many people have to sacrifice behind the scenes inside the truck there. John, Tim, Steve, and Doug, our producer and director, wearing multiple hats, including that black Purdue Fort Wayne one. So our crew, not only tonight, but throughout the season, our players of the game presented by Connor's Kitchen and Bar. Now, if we were to give a player of the game award for someone on the floor, well, Ade Murky could be headlining things. He's got a game-high 18 points right on his season average and now exceeding that as he makes the first and has one more to come.
Here we go again with the Denver press. They're trapping and trapping and they're rotating around and
it forces a turnover. Townsend, big three, doesn't go. Wow. Phillips, another board. He's been the player of the game for the Mastodons. Now it's 16 points and 9 rebounds. Phillips, surging.
Right there, Deontay emerging as one of the superstars here for the Mastodons.
Townsend, Colts. 4 of 17 from the field, including 1 of 7 from 3 tonight. So the sophomore from Dallas, who's one of the leading scorers in the conference this season.
Right here, the Mastodons got to keep the ball out of the corners. Do not throw the ball to the person in the corner. They're going to get trapped. That's been causing a few issues for the Mastodons. Right there's the trap. He got rid of it quickly. Get the ball to the middle, reverse it, and up the court. Perfect execution. Right here, Mastodons run some clock, run some good offense. They don't need to be chucking it up to the rim first available. But that's why I'm sitting with you.
We had 2:10 to go here. But ultimate game of the regular season for both sides. Mastodons already know they'll be the 7th seed in the Summit League tournament. A reverse layup for Roscoe Eastman, and Rodney Phillips now uses a timeout.
Timeout called to set up his press and exactly get players where they want them on the floor. And then on the other hand, Coach Kaufman, he's got to draw something up to break that press here. Like you said earlier, get the ball in quickly, get the ball to the middle, reverse the ball, and then advance it.
With Jeff Parrish, Sean Nolan with you here on a snowy Wednesday night in the Summit City. Mastodons, they'll be in the Horizon League next year. And after tonight, though, one more regular season game to go. That'll be in Tulsa, Oklahoma at Oral Roberts on Saturday. And like we've told you, for Denver, their season may very well come down to their home game on Saturday against Western Illinois. Those two teams right now in the basement of the standings, but both pretty capable.
Very capable. And, you know, Rodney Phillips, he might feel a little pressure. You know, last year finished in the cellar, and there's no way he wants to finish there again this year because I'm sure then a lot of questions will be starting to be asked about him and his team and where he's going to be taking this team in the future.
Yeah, he led Denver to a winning season in his first campaign, year 2, 15-15, and now a second consecutive losing year. That said, a lot of promise for Denver considering 11 of their 13 scholarship players are freshmen or sophomores.
And that's an advantage for him. You know, he's got room to grow and get these kids nurtured. And you can see some of them have some talent. And the Murky kid, the senior, that is the huge contributor that they're going to be losing.
Cameron Benford fouled there, putting Purdue Fort Wayne in the bonus. Benford on the year, 9 of 19 at the line.
Neck foul came straight from Coach Phillips in that timeout.
No, in your scouting report, right?
Exactly. He knew exactly who to foul when they got the ball and they executed it.
And now Benford commits a foul. That's his first foul tonight. Cam, most of the season, when he wakes up in the morning before he brushes his teeth, he's already in foul trouble. Here tonight has done a better job of that.
He's done a great job on the boards as well.
Phillips thought he had a block. Instead, Eastman is going to the line.
Deontay straight up, didn't even leave his feet that time. That must have caught him on the arm a little bit.
So Eastman to the line. A native of Marietta, Georgia, just like Purdue Fort Wayne guard Demir Black.
Did they know each other?
Went to different high schools, but part of that same basketball culture down there in Georgia. In fact, Eastman went to the same high school as Jaylen Brown of the Celtics, Wheeler High.
Here we go on the made free throw. They miss it.
70% foul shooter misses. Something to consider here for the final 95 seconds. Purdue Fort Wayne has the worst free throw shooting percentage as a team in the league at 67%. Denver, second worst, although the Pioneers were an awful 62% from the line in non-conference. They've been superior in league play at 75%. Deontay Phillips bricks the front end of a 1-1.
That was a huge opportunity right there. Create some distance between them.
Door still open, a crack. Murky to Jones.
That's not good right there. Here comes the pressure again.
It's a one possession game with 1:15 to go. Denver has come from 19 points down to pull within three late. John Kaufman wanted to call a timeout. It wasn't noticed by the officials. And now the Macedons will play through.
Just take care of the ball here. Run some shot clock. Nothing crazy.
Shot clock at 5. It's Phillips for 3. Bang!
Right there. Could be the icing on the cake right there.
Murky doesn't have the answer. T. Berry the rebound, and one of the Mastodon's better foul shooters going to the line. Deontay Phillips, the freshman, continuing to impress.
I would think Deontay would have to be in the conversation for newcomer team in the Summit League.
Without a doubt. D. Berry, a 77% career foul shooter. The senior trying to help put this one away. Another look at the Phillips dagger.
Here we go. The Macedons now just play some straight up defense. They don't need to gamble or anything. No fouls. They got this well in hand.
There's the 11th rebound of the night for Dylan Carl, who's 1 point shy of a double-double.
It's his chance right here, going to the free throw line with two shots.
Yeah, Don's in the double bonus now, so Carl on the cusp of a double-double. And rebounding has been a number that has jumped off the page here tonight. Mastodons plus 16, including plus 10 on the offensive glass.
Wind blew that one a little bit.
A wintry night here in late February. Snow outside. And the Mastodons' regular season home finale.
There you go.
Double-double for Dylan Carl.
Good-looking shot that time. Great rotation, good arch. Nothing but net.
And that's the first double-double of Carl's career.
Don't get sloppy with the ball here. Just get it across the 10-second line. You can run the clock out.
Shot clock off.
Denver, I don't look for them. Don't look for them to foul or anything.
Mastodon's timeout here, a 30-second timeout with just 8.2 left. So Purdue Fort Wayne, barring a disaster down the stretch, will snap the three-game skid. Mastodon's on the verge of improving to 12-2 all time against Denver. They wish they could bring the Pioneers with them to the Horizon League. They'll go to 6-1 against the Pioneers at home. And win their sixth in a row in this series. It was against Denver here last year that Matt Holba had a career-high 23 points. Tonight, it's been the freshman, Deontay Billups, who has led the way. Murky with a meaningful shot for some. Makes it a 4-point difference to end this game. But in the end, they're too little, too late from Denver offensively after they scored just 14 points in the first half.
Great defensive effort that first half by the Mastodons. Extremely, again, that turnover bug caught up with them again the second half, and they turned it over there several times in a row and led to Denver baskets. Murky got hot from the perimeter, hit four in a row at one time. Lucky to escape with the win.
And it looks like that final three for Murky may have been waved off after a review, but in any case, it's the Mastodons who win their final home game as a member of the Summit League. Still one more regular season road game to go at Oral Roberts. We'll talk about that next when we come back.
The Acme Bar and Grill, where neighbors meet. A Fort Wayne tradition since 1941. We feature nightly dinner specials along with our iconic pizza, wings, and pork tenderloins, and barbecue in our family-friendly atmosphere with a retro flair. Additionally, we offer a full bar with 26 beers on tap from various Midwest breweries. We also have an area perfect for private events such as meetings, reunions, and banquets that holds up to 50 people. The Acme Bar and Grill, located in the heart of East State Village, where neighbors meet.
At Diamond Residential Mortgage, we understand the importance of keeping pace with technology, and we offer a completely digital loan process to our customers who choose to take advantage of that option. But we also understand the magnitude of a home purchase, and one of our loan officers will work with you every step of the loan process to make sure all your questions are answered and the right type of loan is tailored to fit your needs. See Diamond Residential Mortgage.
In its fourth decade, the Summit League continues its ascent through excellence in the classroom and success in the field of play. In cities big and small, at public and private universities, more than 120,000 students across 9 institutions reach for the Summit. From academic All-Americans to NCAA champions and nationally ranked teams, Summit League student athletes achieve the pinnacle of success. The Summit League, where tomorrow's leaders reach the summit today.
Every time you show up, you make the game, and they make history. March 28th and 30th in Fort Wayne, Indiana. Nothing beats the crowd. Visit ncaa.com/WBB tickets to get your seats today.
For the final time this season from the Hilliard Gate Sports Center on the Purdue Fort Wayne campus, the Mastodons send their seniors out with a victory. 7-point win over Denver, as Matt Holba and Marcus D. Berry go out at home on top.
Both played significant roles here tonight, significant roles throughout their career. Like we said earlier, hey, it's not over yet. Got a big game at Oral Roberts and then the Summit League tournament where we all know they want to make a big splash, especially their last time going to Sioux Falls for that tournament. But, hey, held on here tonight to win, like we've said last few times, win ugly, as Coach Kaufman calls it. And, again, it wasn't the prettiest thing. 21 turnovers for the Mastodons, kind of caught up with them. But a huge night on the backboards for the Mastodons. 48 rebounds, 13 of those offensive. A huge, huge night rebounding the basketball.
Final numbers brought to you by PolyPro Concrete Coatings. And here tonight we saw Purdue Fort Wayne limit Denver to 14 points in the first half. For the Mastodons, who've been Division I for about two decades now, that was the lowest point total against in a half against a Division I opponent, as the Mastodons' win ugly mentality paid off for them here late in the season.
Take that mentality a couple of steps further, and they're going to need contributions from all their stars. The seniors, they got to step up here the next week. Deontay Billups has to play at another high level. Cut those turnovers down, and they'll be able to play with anybody, I think, in the conference tournament.
Yeah, still one more regular season game to go for the Mastodons. That'll be in Tulsa, Oklahoma on Saturday night, and then the league will be done with the regular season. Mastodons already know that they'll be the 7 seed playing against either North Dakota State or South Dakota State, who play each other tomorrow night, and that in all likelihood will sort out who winds up as the top seed.
Hey, one shout out from me, Lana and Doug Ferguson. Amazing job this year. The graphics that we have seen throughout the season, hey, it's big time. I mean, they have done an excellent job. They've really stepped up their game in the graphics and their production. I don't think we've had too many flaws throughout the season this year, and what an excellent job those guys have done with their crew in the back, and I just want to applaud them for the effort and the time they put in to bring these broadcasts to Fort Wayne fans.
Well, very well said.
And I look forward to listening to you this summer hitting the road with the Tin Caps.
Yep, baseball season will be here before you know it, but right now still crunch time for college hoops. And so, as you said, big thanks to everyone behind the scenes on our crew, led by Doug and Lana Ferguson, but so many working tirelessly, looking good, including Tim Badgemo with the mustache and the truck operating instant replay for our broadcast this year. Big thanks to everyone, John Richards, Steve, right inside there too. Couldn't be done without them. And final thank you, though, would be to those of you who've tuned in here throughout the season and watching the Mastodons, who end up on top here tonight on senior night. Matt Holba on both ends of the floor, a factor in his final home game under John Kaufman, a 58-51 win for the Dons. Keep up with Purdue Fort Wayne now online at GoMastodons.com. Well, for Jeff Parrish and everyone else behind the scenes, this is John Nolan saying thanks and so long from the Hilliard Gate Sports Center on the campus of Purdue Fort Wayne in Fort Wayne, Indiana.
This has been a presentation from Learfield IMG College.